हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक इन ईवीएस टू क्लास। होप यू ऑल आर गुड एंड स्टडिंग वेल एट होम। इन प्रीवियस लेसन वी हैड लर्नड अबाउट द सोर्सेस ऑफ वाटर। वी गेट ऑल द वाटर फ्रॉम रेन। वी शुड कलेक्ट रेन वाटर। We also learned that how rivers and lakes are formed. So children, today we are going to learn the properties and states of water from lesson number 10, more about water. Now students, see this glass of water. Can you tell me what is the color of the water? Yes, it is colorless. Means water has no color. Now try to smell a fragrant flower. Yes, you come to know that the flower has sweet smell. Then try to smell the glass of water. Can you tell me what is the smell of water? Yes, it is odorless. Means water has no smell. Children, do you like mango? Yes. Okay then, can anybody tell me what is the taste of ripe mango? Yes, the ripe mango tastes sweet. Now taste the water. How does it taste? Yes, the water has no taste. That is tasteless. Means here we come to know that pure water has no color, no taste and no smell. Kids, let us try to see a candle through a cardboard. Can we see it? No, we cannot see the candle through cardboard because the cardboard is opaque. Here, opaque means if you cannot see through a substance, it is said to be opaque. Now, we will try to see the candle through the glass. Can we see it? Yes, we can see the candle through the glass because the glass is transparent. Here, transparent means if you can see through a substance, it is said to be transparent. Now, like a glass, we will try the same thing with the glass of water. We will try to see the candle through the glass of water. Can we see it? Yes, we can see the candle through it. That means water is transparent too. Children, pure water has no color, no smell, no taste, and it is transparent. Hey kids, let's try this. Take two plates. In first plate, put a little flour, and in second plate, pour some water. Now, observe these two plates carefully. Here we come to know that in the first plate the flour forms a small heap, whereas in second plate water spread. Means water takes the shape of plate. One more example we will see. Take a bowl and a glass. In this both container, pour some water. Now, observe both containers. See, water has taken the shape of bowl and also the shape of glass. It means water takes the shape of the container in which it poured or kept. Dear students, that means water does not have a shape of its own. That is why it spreads on a flat surface or floats down a slope. So kids, these are the properties of water. That is, it has no color, no smell, no taste. It is transparent. It has no shape and it spreads and flows. Children, now we will learn about the different states of water. Here, state means the form in which a substance may be found. See here, the water we use every day is liquid state. When we freeze it, it becomes ice. Ice is the solid state of water. If the ice is left uncovered, it gets heat from the air around it. And the ice will melt again into water. If we heat the water, it will boil and boiling will be convert the water into steam. That is water vapor. Here, vapor is the state of water in which it is a gas. So, water vapor is the gaseous state of water. Here, water vapor means the form in which water is held in the air. So kids, the three states of water are solid state, that is ice, liquid state, that is water, and gaseous state, that is water vapor. Now, let's try this. Take a glass, wipe it dry inside and outside with a clean piece of cloth. Then, place 5 or 6 ice cubes in the glass. What do you see? Yes, it is no surprise of the glass becomes wet on the inside. But children, you see that the outside of the glass has also become moist. What do you think? Isn't that strange? Then, what does this tell us? Yes, the air around the glass contains water vapor. When we put ice cubes in the glass becomes cold. That makes the air around the glass cold too. Then the water vapor which present in the air also cools and forms very tiny droplets of water and they make the glass moist. Hey kids, let us do one activity. You will do it with the help of parents. Children, we know that our mother makes the chapatis on pan every day, right? Now, when chapatis have been made and the pan is still very hot, sprinkle a few drops of water on it. Children, what do you see? Yes, you can see the drops sprinkled on the pan become round like beads, and these appear even as you watch. Here, disappear means it becomes impossible to find. Hey kids, why this thing is happened? Yes, because the pan is very hot and the heat from the pan changes the water into water vapor all at once. Children, try this. Take water in a glass. Then mix a tablespoon of salt in it. Now stir the water with a spoon and test it. Then tell me, how does it taste? Yes, the taste is salty. When the salt is added to water, it dissolves and disappears, making the water salty in taste. Students, like salt, many other substances, for example, sugar, alum, etc., dissolve in water and do not change the color of water. Children, do you know? Alum is used for many purposes. It is used to purify muddy water. In earlier days, men used alum after shaving to stop bleeding from small cuts. It is used in the form of gels or creams for skin care. Hey kids, do you know? Water has to be frozen to make ice. Many people have refrigerators in which ice can be made. In factories, ice is made in large quantities. And children, your favorite ice candy or ice fruit is made by freezing water to which sugar, fruit juice and color have been added. Students, always remember, we know that liquid water has many uses, but the solid ice and the gaseous water vapor are also useful in many ways. I hope you all have enjoyed the lesson. Children, do more practice of learning and complete your writing work on time. Okay? See you soon. Till then, thank you. Take care. Goodbye.